Hello friends, in this part we are going to study about Standard 10th Science and Technology Part 2, Topic Number 6, Animal Classification. Variety of organism we see in nature. Five kingdom classification of organism discovered by scientist Robert Whittaker in 1959. R.H. Whittaker categorized all organisms in five kingdoms, that are Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. In 9th standard, you studied about Kingdom Plantae. There is a variety we found in plants like that. Varieties of animals around us. Some animals are too small, whereas some are too big. Some animals are terrestrial, whereas some are aquatic. Some animals crawl on land, some swims in water, whereas some fly in air. Some animals have scales on skin, whereas some have feathers or hairs. In this way, there is a huge variety among the animals too. According to recent studies, estimated number of animal species on Earth is approximately million, and so it is impossible to study each and every species. However, if groups and subgroups of animals are found depending upon the similarities and differences, it will make it very easy to study such vast variety of animals. Traditional method of animal classification. Traditionally, depending upon presence or absence of the notochord, the animal kingdom has been divided into two groups. First one, non-chordates, and second one, chordates. Subkingdom non-chordates are classified or divided into 10 phyla. Those phyla are Protozoa, Porifera, Cylindrata, Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Ascelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and Hemichordata. Phylum Porifera. These animals are with simplest body plan and are called as sponges. They bear numerous pores on their body. Those pores are called as ostia and oscula. These are aquatic animals. Most of them are marine and few are freshwater dwellers. Most of the animals have a symmetrical body. These animals have special type of cells are collar cells. These animals are always attached to substratum, hence do not show locomotion. Hence, they are referred as sedentary animals. Their spongy body is supported by spicules or spongin fibers. Spicules are made up of calcium carbonate or silica. These animals feed upon small organisms taken in their body along with water. Water is in through ostia and given out through oscula. These animals reproduce by budding and asexual reproduction or by sexual method. Besides, they have good ability of regeneration. The example of phylum Porifera are Cycon, Euspongia, means bath sponge, Hylonema, and Euplectella. Phylum Cylindrata or Cnidaria. Body of these animals is cylindrical or umbrella-like. If it is cylindrical, it is called as polyp, and if it is umbrella-like, called as medusa. Most of these animals are marine. Only few are freshwater dwellers. Body of these animals is radially symmetrical or diploblastic. Nidoblast bearing tentacles are present around the mouth. Tentacles are useful for capturing the prey, whereas nidoblasts inject the toxin in the body of prey. Those are helpful for protection too. Example of phylum Cylindrata are Hydra, sea anemone, Physalia, that is man of war, Aralia, that is jellyfish, and corals. Phylum Platyhelminthes. Body of these animals is slender and flat like a leaf or strip. Hence, they are called as flatworms. Most of these animals are endoparasites. Few are free living and aquatic. Body is acoelomate and bilaterally symmetrical. These are triploblastic, that is, their body is made up of three germ layers, endoderm, ectoderm, and mesoderm. These animals are hermaphrodite, that is, male and female reproductive systems are present in the same animal body. The example of phylum Platyhelminthes are Planaria, liver fluke, tapeworm. Phylum Askhelminthes. Body of these animals is long, thread-like or cylindrical. Hence, they are called as roundworms. These animals are either free-living or endoparasites. Free-living animals are either aquatic or terrestrial. Body of these animals is triploblastic and pseudocoelomate. Body of these animals is non-segmented and covered with tough cuticle. These animals are unisexual. The examples of phylum Askhelminthes are Ascaris, Filaria, Loa, etc. Phylum Annelida. Body of these animals is long, cylindrical, and metamerically segmented. Most of the animals are free living, but few are ectoparasites. Free living animals may be marine or freshwater dwellers or terrestrial. These animals are triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, and eucoelomate. They have setae or parapodia or sucker for locomotion. Their body is covered with special cuticle. These animals are either hermaphrodite or unisexual. Example of phylum Annelida are earthworm, leech, and Neris. Phylum Arthropoda. These animals have jointed appendages. Hence, they are called as arthropods. Planet Earth has highest number of animals from this phylum. Hence, this is largest phylum with highly successful animals in animal kingdom. These animals are found in all type of habitats ranging from deepest oceans to highest mountains. Body of these animals is triploblastic, eucoelomate, bilaterally symmetrical, and segmented. chitinous exoskeleton is present around their body. These animals are unisexual. The example of phylum Arthropoda are crab, spider, scorpion, millipede, centipede, cockroach, butterfly, and honeybee. Phylum Mollusca. Body of these animals is soft and slimy. Hence, they are referred as mollusks. This is second largest phylum in animal kingdom. These animals are aquatic or terrestrial. Most of the aquatic mollusks are marine, but few are freshwater dwellers too. Body of these animals is triploblastic, eucelomate, and non-segmented and soft. Except animals like snail, their body shows bilateral symmetry. Their body is divided into three divisions like head, foot, and visceral mass. Visceral mass is covered with mantle. This mantle secretes a hard calcareous shell. This shell may be external or internal or even absent in some cases. These animals are unisexual. The examples of phylum Mollusca are bivalve, snail, and octopus. Phylum Echinodermata. Calcareous spines are present on the body of these animals. Hence, they are called as echinoderms. These animals are found only in ocean. Their body is triploblastic, eucelomate, and it is radially symmetrical in adult stage. However, they shows bilateral symmetry in larval stage. They perform locomotion with the help of tube feet. Tube feet are also useful for capturing the prey. Some animals are sedentary. They have skeleton made up of calcareous spines. These animals have good ability of regeneration. These animals are mostly unisexual. The examples of echinodermata are starfish, sea urchin, brittle star, sea cucumber. Phylum Hemichordata. Body of these animals is divided into three parts as proboscis, collar, and trunk. Notochord is present in proboscis region only. Hence, they are called as hemichordates. These animals are also called as acorn worms. These are marine animals, live in burrows in sand. They have one too many pharyngeal glial slits. They are unisexual, or some may be hermaphrodite. The example of phylum Hemichordata are Balanoglossus, Sacoglossus, etc. Friends, in this part we have studied about classification of non-chordates. In second part, we are going to study about classification of chordates. Thank you.